the land of opportunity. Demonstrates your talent and rise to become the most powerful transport company in the most powerful country in the world. The future lies in the West. We will bring progress to this barren swath of land full of simple-minded country bumpkins and savage natives. But transporting the required goods is painstaking and expensive. A railroad from east to west, now that would be a real gold mine. But the competition never sleeps. The Central Pacific Railroad has already started construction on a line from the Pacific. Let's beat them to it and open up the Wild West. Welcome to the Wild West. It is the year 1864, and we find ourselves in the tranquil settlement of Cheyenne, somewhere in the middle of nowhere. The tracks from the east end here. Our job, to construct a railroad line to the west, the first transcontinental railroad in the whole of America. The investors have given us a rather modest sum of money, but that'll have to do if we don't want to scare them off. If the competition carries on working at the current pace, they're expected to reach the goal before us. Let's spare ourselves this disgrace and get started. If we want to beat the competition to the goal, we'll need more workers, and workers need feeding. Once the men are half full, this business with food could generate some extra income for us. Let construction begin. In order not to fritter away our meager starting capital already on the first leg of the journey, it'd be sensible to choose a route that avoids costly blasting operations to build tunnels.
Thank you.
Wonderful. This one leg completed already. However, we're already encountering our first difficulties. It was very good of the government to place this land at our disposal free of charge. If it weren't for those damned Indians. They've pitched their tents right in the middle of our planned route. Our scouts seem to think they're rather displeased with the white man and his iron horse, and that's us. Those damned Indians. They're sabotaging our work and are said to have physically attacked some of our men. We need to do something. We have various options. Either we buy them a piece of land of equivalent value, which could get pretty costly, or we could settle it the old-fashioned way, which would probably cost us our good reputation in certain circles. Or else we could try to bribe them with firewater, although its consumption is known to make one rather aggressive. problem with the Indians has been settled, but we've already encountered our next challenge. Before us lie miles and miles of nothing but bone-dry steppe. We'll need to make sure we don't run out of water. However, there should be iron ore deposits that we can exploit to earn a bit of extra money and to produce tools. The workers are refusing to lift a finger. They're claiming that they haven't been paid for months. No idea whether that's right, but we're pretty short on money, and it's only a matter of time before the investors pull the plug on funding us. We could put off paying our guys until next month and promise them double wages in return. Or there's another alternative over in Ogden. Pious, hardworking people live in Ogden who outright refuse to accept the progress of civilization. They would work for us for almost nothing. In return, we only need to help them build a new bridge so that they can get their harvest across the river to the village. Good. Finally, it's back to work. Unfortunately, our tools are worn out and dreadfully inefficient. We should have our men make new ones. There's an abundance of iron ore in the area. This will save us money and we'll make faster progress. Our loan has already been used up. The investors won't like that. But if we ask nicely, maybe they'll give us a little bit more. The investors are highly displeased with the wasteful squandering of their resources, as they put it. If only they knew what everything costs. The new tools are a blessing. They've made our work much easier. Now quickly over the hill to Ogden. And from there, we're just a stone's throw from our destination. So come on, chop chop. Just one vanity project such as this has the potential to ruin savvy businessmen, like our sponsors. They've granted us one final loan, but soon they'll be broke themselves. We can't keep our financial backers happy for much longer. They say this is the last time they'll be giving us a loan. Now they're cutting off our money supply. Out of pure human kindness, the investors are willing to give us a helping hand this one final time, but then that's it. Let construction begin. In order not to fritter away our meager starting capital already on the first leg of the journey, it'd be sensible to choose a route that avoids costly blasting operations to build tunnels. Wonderful. This one leg completed already. However, we're already encountering our first difficulties. It was very good of the government to place this land at our disposal free of charge. If it weren't for those damned Indians. They've pitched their tents right in the middle of our planned route. Our scouts seem to think they're rather displeased with the white man and his iron horse, and that's us.